What's up, everybody, and welcome to Trav's Travel Channel. As many of you know, last week I was at a shipper. I was there for over 10 hours, and they ran my clock out because they were running so slow to get me loaded. Well, I ended up leaving the next day with the load. I get 132 miles down the highway and get a phone call from my driver manager telling me to turn around, take that load back to the Salt Lake City terminal and give it to a team. So, okay, no problem. I go ahead and do that. And I get 6 miles out from the terminal. I look at the gauge on my Reaper trailer and it's reading a yellow K. Yellow K is bad news. So I pull over. Reaper says that it's low on fuel. I look at the fuel tank, it's empty. When I left out that day, it had between 3/4 and 1/2. So something obviously mechanically was wrong. I took it to the terminal where we determined that there was a 2-inch stress fracture in the Reaper fuel tank that caused all my fuel to leak out. So in order to save the load, I had to take the trailer to a Thermo King, which they got it on it real quick and got a new fuel tank put on and put some fuel in it. Well, while I was sitting at the Thermo King, another driver walked in there and said that he was there for that trailer, and nobody had called me and told anything, which I'm cool with that. You know, that's part of trucking. It's nobody's fault. There was some miscommunication. Okay, I'm good with that. Well, anyways, lo and behold, I ended up keeping the load. I get a phone call yesterday from my DM stating that the load is now not due to be delivered into the Mira Loma, California area until Monday morning at 3:15. But the good news is that she got me a load coming out of that area going to Texas, which is where I've been wanting to go for a while. Now, hey, that's great. That's all said and done. Now I'm sitting here in Fontana and I'm doing another 44-hour restart like you guys saw in my previous videos. And, you know, which is cool. I understand it's part of trucking, but I have a serious gripe with the U.S. government regarding my passport. In their infinite wisdom, they decided to mail my passport to my mother's house, but not return my birth certificate. That's very bad on you, Mr. Government. Bad, bad mojo. You should never, ever send a passport out without returning the original birth certificate that was submitted with it. I called them as soon as I found out my birth certificate wasn't there, and I found out that they mailed it out 2 days after my passport has been mailed out. So now, not only I have to have my birth certificate to go onto the British Virgin Islands, which I told you guys that they require a passport, birth certificate, driver's license, and that's also what the cruise line is requiring for embarkation in Miami. And I'm cool with that if the government would return my passport. Actually, sorry, my birth certificate. I want my birth certificate back. But anyways, I'm sitting here in Fontana, California, just been enjoying my time here, relaxing, and I will shoot you guys some more video maybe later on today or tomorrow. But until then, stay tuned. Peace. Thanks for watching. Please hit the subscribe button or contact me at the following links.